I'm calling you.
Thank you.
And welcome to the program. You're listening to the Costa Show. Today is Friday, the 11th of December 2020. The time in Monrovia is 7:30. It just struck 7:30 a.m. in Monrovia. The time in Wilmington, in Bear, Delaware, it's 2:30. And I'm Henry Costa, your servant, and I'm very glad to be here. My co-host, Barkai, is not feeling very well, so he will not be joining me this morning on the show. So I'm going to be here alone today. It's the beginning of the weekend, and I'm very glad to be here. And because a lot has been going on throughout the week. And it has been a very historic week, very difficult, very stressful. I apologize for my not being on a show yesterday. Sometimes it's so tough, and we've been working a lot. And so I'm very glad that I can be here today. I just want to say to you all, as I said, I just want to re-echo my plea I made yesterday in that podcast that we should go easy on ordinary citizens, the ordinary ones who are just like us, who have, as you can see, most of them have become quiet. You don't hear them making big mouth. Most of them. They're suddenly fallen silent. Nobody likes defeat, especially not these terrible defeats. And so I urge all of you to go easy on them. I'm not talking about the big ones. I'm talking about the ordinary citizens. You know, we should do that. And the election results, of course, we're continuing to tally our results. We're almost done from our war room from Monserrato County and from other counties as well. These results show that the CPP has done very, very well across the country. We've done extremely well across the country. And I'm very glad about that. I'm sure you all are about how fantastically well we've performed. You know, from our war room, we're continuing to tally. I don't have the latest results since yesterday, but for those of you who didn't watch my podcast yesterday, so you wouldn't know, but these are the latest results from our war room from yesterday. I don't have fresh ones. To those of my folks listening from the war room, kindly send me fresh results, latest results from our war room. Darius Delon, CPP, 167,929 votes. 167,929 votes, representing 63% of the votes. Thomas Pangafala, 92,279 votes. That's 34% of the votes. And according to the tally from our war room, they're reporting about 81%. So we're left about 18%. So that's about 81% of the tally votes from our war room. So we're left with about 20%, just about 18%, 18.66%. That would be around 370 polling places. So we had a total of 1,983 polling places, and so far 1,613 of them. That's 18.1%. That's the results from our war room. 81.34%. And we've got 167,929 votes. That's 62.27%, Thomas Bella has 92,279%. That's 34.22%. That's how it stands in our war room. We're still tallying by today. I assure you, we should be done. We should be done by today. And okay, fantastic. So you know, the numbers look good, very, very good. And this thing is a wrap, you know. And I, as I said yesterday in my podcast, the government need to focus now on the situation regarding how badly they have performed. These election results do not reflect on the candidate Thomas Fah personally. They reflect on the government, particularly the president, because of the way he's performed. That's why the results are this bad. But defeat sometimes is a good thing, especially when you have the opportunity to change, to turn things around. There are lots of things they have to do. George Weah will have to do a complete 360 if he wants to have any shot at winning back some of the favor of the people he's lost. Now, the country is not divided down the middle. No, it is not. The country is divided, fundamentally skewed. It is fundamentally skewed. That means we have controlled only about 32% of the country. Only about 32% of the country he controls. But about 68 to 70% of the population does not support George Weah. This is scary for them. And they need to wake up. Most of the country does not support them. Most of the country does not support the president. You know, this is time for the president to wake up and say, hey, you know what? I need to wake up. Yes, my friend, he needs to do a 180. Thank you. A 180. Yeah, that's what he needs to do. He needs to do a 180 turnaround and say, look, things are bad. This is a message to me. It may be a defeat personally for Thomas Fah, but it's a much bigger defeat to George Weah. These elections were about the president's popularity. They were about the president's performance. And so far, as we all know, his performance has been bad. Now, do they need further evidence that the Liberian people are not happy? Do they need further confirmation that the things we say here every morning are true, that the people are unhappy, they are bitter, and they are hurt by the way he's governing the country? No, of course not. This is enough, sufficient evidence that is humiliating. And so the president has an opportunity. The opportunity that he has is that he is still in power. You know, some of my friends have actually said to me, Costa, you shouldn't be advising this man. Leave them, let them do whatever they want to do. Let them continue to destroy the country. So, but the thing is, I don't want them to destroy the country. I don't really care about George Weah. I don't care about McGill. I don't care about Tuer. But I'm just telling them that the defeat that they have sustained as humiliating and devastating as it is, as it may be, it should be a lesson. They should draw strength from it. They should say to themselves, this is a message for the people. Nothing else but a message. And they should try to turn things around. But do I believe that George Weah can change? I don't believe it. You know? Do I believe that McGill is going to suddenly change his attitude and they're going to stop witch hunting people? They're going to stop suppressing people? They're going to stop behaving as though the country belongs to them? They're going to stop pushing people out of the country? Look at what they did to me personally. You know? They still have my equipment worth $100,000. Our radio equipment, our recording studio equipment. We had just set up a brand new recording studio. These guys moved in, seized all of our equipment. And they still have them. Over a year now, then they think that I'm going to like them. And how am I going to be nice to these people who, by all means, have shown me that they hate my guts? If they had an opportunity, they would kill me. And so I don't have any love for them. And I don't care about them. And I want them out of power, period. I want them out of power. And you know, sometimes when they're wondering, oh, why does Costa hate us? Why is Costa so hard on us? I want to tell you this. You guys are wicked. Look at what you did to me. Look at what you did to me personally. I have personal issues with you. Apart from the way you're treating the Liberian people, my issues are personal as well. You know, you sold diplomatic passports to criminals. Besson Gafele sold honorary council positions to criminals. Shady characters. And that's not a problem for you. But you went after me over a silly issue. A laissez-passer. You claim that I forged a laissez-passer. How dare I do such a stupid thing? You know, I entered the country December 9, 19. You accepted the document. You stamped it. You allowed me into the country. No query whatsoever. After our protest on January 6th, I'm about to return. Then you tried to harass me. Chase me. I crossed into Sierra Leone. In a canoe, late night, in a dark, dirty river. God knows what could have happened, God forbid, had that canoe capsized. Then you chase me into Sierra Leone, as if to say I'm some threat to the country, like I've done some horrible, terrible thing, like I've committed treason, like I had attempted to overthrow the government. You waste resources trying to go after me because you are unhappy by how I have made you look like over the years since you've come to power. And all we've done is to express ourselves and tell the Liberian people the truth about how you have behaved to them. Tried to get the Sierra Leonean government to extradite me. They refused to extradite me. It became an international situation. It embarrassed you. The Sierra Leoneans refusing to extradite me was a terrible embarrassment. You are a less basic bunch of people wasting resources chasing a talk show host and an advocate because he organized protests to bring thousands of people out to a peaceful protest. What is wrong with you? And you think these things are supposed to make me to like you or to not be angry and bitter like the rest of the country? Of course, I'm angry and bitter like the rest of the country. Folks, I am. I am like the rest of the country. And to look at you now, look at you now, folks. See what you've done to yourself. And you know, you're sitting there wondering, how did we come to this? Two things. Your behavior, your actions, and us educating the Liberian people about what you've done. Two things. That's how it came to down. It came down to this. We've been educating the people about how you behave. We've been telling them things they didn't even know. Exposing you. Dropping bombshells, as we call them. And this is it. So you see, my people, you don't want to change. You don't change. They're your business. Do I really care whether George Weah changes? I don't think it's possible that George Weah will change. I don't think so. Yesterday, look at what your convoy did. Our people were at our headquarters, at the Liberty Party headquarters. Our candidate, Darius Delon, had just given a speech. Our people read out some of the results from our war room. Our partisans and our supporters were there, celebrating peaceably. Your convoy is heading towards town. Your pilot vehicle runs into one of our supporters. They could have killed him. They broke his leg. They broke his leg. Then later on, you issue a statement. You know, I'm surprised you didn't deny it. I am surprised. To be honest, the surprise I had about that statement is that you did not deny it. The president expressed what did he express? His sympathy, his sorry about what happened to our supporter. That young man could have lost his leg. He could have lost more than his leg. He could have lost his life. For Christ's sake, he could have lost his life. But for God, he could have lost his life. He's at ELWE Hospital. We are providing him treatment. The doctors managed to salvage his leg, to put it in a cast. They operated on him, on his leg. I'm surprised. Then Patrick Sudu, the police director, apparently the president sent him to the family. He goes to the family's house. Folks, this is what Patrick Sudu did. He goes to the home of the family, of this young boy's family. He doesn't even ask to sit down. And the camera is on him, because the media people were there. I think from Spoon TV. Patrick Sudu does not even sit down. He does not even remove his police hat out of respect for the family, for what has just happened to their son. He stands up there. He reaches into his pocket and he takes out some insignificant amount of money and he hands the money to the boy's mother. He doesn't sit down. He doesn't remove his hat out of respect. It's a gesture of respect. We see it here in America. Police officers, military people, you know, when they want to show respect, they remove their hat. Sulu didn't remove his hat. Maybe he doesn't have that training. He stands up there. He blabbers a few words. He reaches into his pocket. He takes out a little bit of money. He hands it to the boy's mother. You think this is just about money? It is not just about money. Now, folks, you all say the boy has died. He hasn't died. He is alive. He's at a hospital. We're taking care of him. He's a COP supporter. The COP, yesterday, Chairman Dukle, Sister Musu, Sister Winifred, Sister Wito Bryan is the one that went to the hospital. And the COP folks have been involved. And we are taking care of him. A friend of mine reached out to me yesterday and offered to provide some cash. We're going to take care of him. We're going to pay for the medical bill, and we're doing that. We don't need the government to help us. He is not dead. He is not dead. I can say this to you. He is not dead. We are taking care of him. He's at a hospital. If he were dead, I would tell you, he's not dead. They saved his leg. The doctors operated on his leg. They put in a cast. He's not going to lose his leg. So I can tell you this much. The boy is alive. He's not dead. And that's good news. So this is what they did. And why were they angry? They were angry because our people were at the headquarters and the election results are going our way. You know? Yeah. This is unfortunate. So at least yesterday they didn't deny that one. Because that's what they do. They lie. They lie about everything. You know? Everything they lie. That audit report came out, about how $32 million was stolen. The audit report, the internal audit report from the LRA, the Liberian Revenue Authority. The audit report came out, your government came out and denied that the audit report even exists. When privately they have communicated with media people and they admitted that the audit report is authentic, then publicly you deny it after $32 million was stolen by your administration. $32 million in 2 years stolen. You think these things, people will know these things and go vote and vote for you? You think they will do that? You think our people are stupid? They're not stupid and they're not going to vote for you after all of these things. Yesterday you heard our hearts. I was pained when I saw that young man's foot. We call on those people. We call on that young man and others to show up at the headquarters of the Liberty Party. We didn't call on them to make trouble. He wasn't making trouble. And you go, you hurt him in that manner. And you send Patrick Sudu to the family's house. He goes there with his uncouth self, no training. He disrespects the family by handing them a little bit of cash. And he walks away. I wish we had a way to return that damn cash to you. We don't need your money. We will take care of this boy. We don't need your money. You are the president for all Liberians. You need to behave like that. But it is not possible. You don't know how to do it. To be president for all. Now we are concerned. What's wrong with the National Elections Commission website? Yesterday, the website was up. They asked, they chairperson of the commission, David Etta Brown Lansana, she said people could go on a website and access information, data, results from the elections. Yet we can't see the website. The website has been down since last night. What happened to the Elections Commission website? My IT guy is telling me that the site was deliberately taken down by the Elections Commission itself. Why did you take the website down? It is a public information platform where people can access, particularly at this time, critical vital results of the 2020 Senate elections. So we need the website to be up. Why did you take the website down? Look at the kind of suspicious things you do. Now we've got people who know what they're doing. My IT guy went and checked the site. He said, Costa, this site did not crash. It was deliberately, willfully taken down. So the Elections Commission needs to tell us, why did you take the website down? Why did you take the website down? We need to know that. The website is where people should go and find information, the results. But then it's been suddenly taken down. And it didn't crash. It didn't suddenly shut down by itself. My IT guy tells me that you took it down. So you need to explain to the Liberian people why you took the website down. It is important. We need to know that. Yeah. We need to know that. Now, listen. We're going to take care of this boy that was hurt. We're going to take care of him all the way. Even when he gets out of the hospital, we will put some more money in his pocket just so when he goes home, because he's not going to be able to hustle and do stuff like that. We'll get him some money just so he doesn't have to worry. He will be relaxed and stuff like that. You know, we're going to do that. Yeah. Okay. Thank you. I have a source in the neck. Okay. So I'm told that the site was taken down because of the traffic. I'm told that it will be up by this afternoon. And my IT guy was right that it was taken down by the neck. And my IT guy tells me the reason for which it was taken down is for maintenance purpose, because the traffic overwhelmed the site. And this, my source, I trust. This source that's telling me this. The only reason why I'm saying the things that he told me, because I trust this source implicitly. I have implicit confidence in this source. I know what he says. I know where his loyalties are. That's why I'm even telling you what he said to me just now. So the site was taken down, according to my source. They next took it down, and they're working on it because there's too much traffic. And I can understand that. It does make sense. Too many people are logging on to try to get information. So they got overwhelmed, and they had to take it down. And so that's what my IT guy, my source at the neck just told me. And he also just said to me is that by this afternoon, today, the site should be up. And Stephen Johnson, my friend, you are right. They should have issued a little statement that we are taking our website down because of traffic, and we're going to do some work, and it will be restored. It will be back up. I agree with you, Stephen Johnson. At this very critical point, the NEC should be very forthcoming with everything about their activities, especially that concerns the public. The site is a platform where thousands and thousands of people are logging on to get information. I can understand the traffic at this time, but they should issue a statement so that people do not get alarmed. You do not want to give people reason to start speculating, to start assuming that something is wrong. You don't want to do that. You don't want to do that. You know, I just want to tell you this. The Elections Commission needs to be careful. They need to conduct themselves in a good way. Because if they don't, it's going to create trouble. And today, I expect they're going to announce a huge batch of the results, which I have no doubt that they will do, because they must have tallied a lot of those results by now. The country needs to know so that we can go back to life as we knew it, and put these elections behind us, and the CDC can try to change if they can, which I don't believe they can. It is up to them, but 2023 is only 3 years away. 3 years away, and we will flop them badly. It will not be easy. We'll kick them out of office 3 years away. Now they need to think about their future. They need to think about their future. Nathaniel McGill, Samuel Tuer, Jefferson Koji, Finda Bono, George Weah, Safar May Gray, and all of them, they need to think about their future, because we're coming for them in 3 years' time, and it's not going to be easy. We will give no quarters. We will whip them. We will not be merciful at all. Now, I want to say happy birthday to Timandra Sia Bonge. She's one of the strong supporters of Abraham Darius Delon. Timandra was heavily involved with MADAS, heavily involved with the fundraising that helped provide, paid for the poll watching. She played a pivotal role. The history of the success of Delon's re-election cannot be written without Timandra name being all over it. And I want to say happy birthday to you. She's a beautiful, strong, intelligent, passionate young lady. And she celebrated her birthday yesterday. So I want to exclusively dedicate this morning's show to Timandra Sia Bonge, who celebrated her birthday yesterday. Happy birthday to you. We appreciate you. We admire you. And we salute you for all that you've done and you continue to do for Liberia by your support and shared passion and commitment toward our efforts to, just make democracy work. To just make democracy work. And that's exactly what you've been involved with. So happy birthday to you, my dear. I hope you had a wonderful day yesterday. I want to say to all of our supporters, we appreciate you. We love you, of course, you know. And, you know, as I said to you a few days ago, and I posted on Facebook, these election results, they're personal for me. And they're personal in the sense that I feel that my waking up every morning to be here, either at 2 a.m., which I now do, or at 3 a.m. at some point during the year, I feel justified. I feel like it's worth it. It's worth it, and I have reason to continue to do it because of the way you voted, because of the way you have voted. Makes me feel that I should continue to do what I've been doing because we've been making an impact. And so that is extremely important to me. I just want to say this to you. And I thank you. I thank you for giving me strength. You remember the last time I was complaining a few weeks ago that I didn't feel like what we were doing had any impact or that we were making any difference. You remember a few weeks ago I kept singing that song that I didn't feel like what I was doing was important anymore, that it was making any difference. But you've just shown me that it is important, that the work we do is important. I mean, you could not have sent me a better message. You've just proven to me, Costa, keep doing what you're doing because it is important. All the work we did on with Bessica Finley, you know, you all were just hearing, but oh yeah, they're selling the passports, they sold diplomatic positions, they did this, they did that. But you really did something. You showed us that what we were doing or what we do is important. And when we came with the information on Finley, and if Finley had won the election against Bessonga, I would have really felt bad personally for two reasons. One, because because Finley is a terrible candidate, a terrible person, and Youngley is a better candidate by far. But more than that, when we brought that information on, and we paid money for it and all. You remember? We spent $1,000, not my personal cash, but I got friends who gave me the money we spent. We bought the information, $1,000. The second batch, that letter that the Mexican government wrote to the Liberian government complaining about what we had done by sending the Nigerian criminal to their country without their knowledge and consent. And not only that, the photographs, the certificate of Bessonga Finley presenting the honorary consul position to the Nigerian criminal. And all of those things, we presented those things. And you listened to us in Grand Bassa. The Liberian people listened to us. We forced Finley to do a press conference to defend himself, and his defense was poor and it was not even convincing. He did it in Bassa. And we did those things, and you showed us that, yes, you listened. They made an impact. And so I just want to say thank you. Thank you for renewing my strength. Thank you for giving me strength to continue to do this. Many a times, I get bitter, I get frustrated. There's so much stress associated with the work we do. Some of you think it's just easy to come here and sit here and just talk, but that's not what it is. We are emotionally invested. We are inextricably tied to this work that we do. We cannot divorce ourselves from the work. The work is a part of us. Also, man, I said I should stop insulting. Trust me, I'm not going to stop telling people when they're stupid, they're stupid. I'm not going to stop doing that. When somebody is an idiot, I would tell them that they're an idiot. I would not stop. I'm very sorry. I'm not going to stop that. I would just tell you exactly how I feel. So that's just me. And you have to accept that. If you are an idiot, I will tell you that you are an idiot. If you are a fool, I will tell you that you are a fool. And so that's not going to stop. That's just me. You're not going to change that. I just want to make that very clear to you. So you can either continue to listen to me or you can stop listening to me. But I will not change my diction just to please you. I will not. We're going to go to the phone lines. George Ware is in the studio. We'll take us to the phone lines. Now, we're in Christmas. And send wave, our dear good friends. If you're looking to send money to Liberia, look no further. Send wave is the way to do it. You can send money. Now, let me say this, folks. There's some of you who will say, why our relative or our friend or our loved one paid a fee when they sent me the money from America or from the UK or from Canada or from Spain or Italy or one of those countries from which SendWave sends money to Liberia. But then why did they Lone Star sell MTN cashier or mobile money agent take out some money? Now, they will take out a small fee. We've talked about this. But the fee they should take out is very tiny. It's a small fee. And I have the fee schedule here, but I will not be able to go into that right now. But it's a very small fee. But some of them are irresponsible and they're taking too much out of your money. Now, they only take out a fee if you want to cash out. If you do not cash out, you don't get to pay a fee. If somebody sends you $100 by SendWave, the person will pay only $3 to send you that $100. And if you don't cash out the money, you don't get to pay a fee in Liberia. So that means the sender will have only paid $3 and you, the recipient, will have paid $0 to get your money. But if you wish to cash out your money, then you pay a small fee. And that fee should be small. Now, there is a situation where a number of agents, mobile money agents, are exploiting and duping the customers. That is true. And the way to avoid that, for the most part, is to go to the Lone Star Cell agent, the Lone Star Cell locations. There, they will not deduct the kind of money they will take. And these are just tiny fees that they should take out. But they're taking out more. Like in Liberia, you know, if you have a mobile money account, and somebody, one person sends you money from their mobile money account to your mobile money account, and you wish to cash out that money, you know that you will pay a fee. You know this very, very well. So paying a fee is not a strange thing to you. You pay a cash out fee. It doesn't matter whether the person sends you the money from America or whether the person is standing right next to you. If I'm standing right next to you and I take my phone and reach and go to my mobile money account and I send you money, and that's going to be a problem. And this person is saying, Western Union, you're talking about paying $2,000 for $8. My friend, that is not true. That's not true. That's not true. You don't pay $8 to send $2,000 by Western Union, my friend. I send money to Liberia all the time and I know what I pay. You are a bloody liar. A bloody liar. That is not true. Yes. That's it. $150 is $2.50. SendWave charges you actually... They charge you $3 to send $100. $3. That's what they charge you to send $100. That's the fee. And so when the money goes to Liberia, you're supposed to pay a very small fee. I will try to get the fee schedule and I'll publish it and I'll read it out to you. So that when you go to these agents, you know exactly what to pay. But hey, Bogai, I mean George, let's go to the phone lines and let's take some calls there. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening to you. And what the fees should be small. John K. Flomo Jr., I said they should be small. I'm not saying that the fees are small. There are agents who are deducting more than they should be deducting. They are deducting way more than it should be deducted, and that is not the case. That's not how it should be. The fees should be very small. To get your money out, it should be. Look at this person telling me, oh yeah, the person said, they send $920 and they paid $24. Yeah, you see that the rate is high. So they paid $24, you just send $920 Western Union. With SendWave, you would have only paid $6. This person said, yeah, $40 to send $2,000 with Western Union. You see that? With SendWave, you will pay only $12. Instead of $40 to send $2,000, with SendWave, you will pay only $12. Only $12. Because on every $999 with SendWave, you pay $6. So if you send $2,000, that's $12 with SendWave. You get to save yourself $24. Is it 24? $24. You got 24 and 12 would be what, $40? Would that be 40? I told you my math skills bad. You would have saved yourself some good money. Yeah, about $40. Yeah, I think so. So you got to save a lot. Somebody said they send $500 and they pay $6. Yes, cool. That's same way. You send $500, you pay $6. Now, your loved one or your friend, when they receive that money, they should pay just about $3 or $4 or $5 to get the money. So in total, you will have only paid about $11 or $12 to send $500 to Liberia, which is so cheaper than Western Union or MoneyGram. And then there is the convenience. Don't forget, there's something called convenience fee. You pay for convenience, you know? So there is that also. But let's go to the phone lines. Today's Friday, and we are receiving, I received $200 from SendWave. Why would they possibly be calling me? $200 from SendWave, and he was charged $2.50. Well, that's good. Basically, that's what Lone Star will charge you if you go to the Lone Star official brand. Yeah, you see that? He said he received $200 and he paid $2.50 to get it. The person who sent you that money paid $6 to send it to you. If you paid $2.50 to get it, $6 for $2.50, that means that's $8.50. So you spent under $9 to get $200. That's good. Especially consider the convenience fee. The convenience fee. Thank you, my friend. $24 plus $12 is $36. Thank you. So, still, you would have saved yourself a lot of money. A lot of money. Let's go to the phone lines and take some calls. Josh?
Okay. Yeah?
Yes, let's take some calls. Let's talk to our people. Let's take some calls.
Okay. Good morning.
Good morning, Costa.
Morning.
Yeah, I'm still calling from Monrovia.
Team, let's hear you, team.
Thank you, everybody. I want to tell to the airport, my platform, on your platform. If you play with our phone, even heaven, or even the call of heaven, whatever you say, all of your, none of your, our phone is our future. Our phone is our life. We have spoken to the world that enough is enough. Nobody plays our phone. I'm in 10 years to 5 years, we don't play with our vote. And let me tell you this time. We're not going to war. We have rest your slave near where we are prepared. And I can't admit power. We have rest your slave near where we have left. Nobody left when we push it. We said no to power. We said no to war. That's why we're patient. We're going to call order for the 15 billion dollars. We're really down for rape cases. We're not really being up for the full part of the justice and accountability. The rule of law. The respect of the constitution of the Republic of Liberia. Don't play with our vote. The vote is our children's school fee. Our vote is our life. We need education. We need water. We need security. And we need that we will say enough is enough. That's just in the world of watch. We're not talking about violence.
Okay, Tim. Thank you. Thank you very much, Timothy. Let's take more calls, Josh.
Okay, the number to call on the show this morning is 0770-102-102-086-0103-83. The other number to call, 0777-340-7337. These are the number to call this morning. Let's go back to the phone lines. Good morning. Good morning. Hello? Yes, good morning. Hello? Hello? Oh, we lost our caller there. Okay, the numbers are called 0770102102 0886 0103 3. Okay, now go back. Good morning.
Hello?
Yes, good morning.
Good morning, good morning.
Yes? Your name, where are you calling from?
Yeah, good morning, Pedro. Good morning, John. Good morning to the three lessons of my year. My name is Amar Mohamed Kamara. Good morning, Pedro.
Morning, Amar.
Pedro, they come in along the online, they have just said, that other life on our she has to be very careful. The Latin people have spoken, and there's nothing beyond that. Any extension on the election results, as we probably said, we will not go back to war. We have no mindset of going back to war. But we will create a political event, one by one. My call this morning is to tell a strong idea to the National Electoral Commission. Let us demonstrate the will of the constitution and the will of the Latin people. On the contrary to that, we are very, very 100,000 times prepared to reduce any number. Thank you very much.
Okay. The numbers of God this morning, the show 0770102102 0886 0103 3. The other numbers of God 0777 340 7 7. Let's go back. Good morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
Yes, good morning.
Yes.
Your name, where are you calling from?
Calling from Kibata. Kikudori.
Welcome to the program.
Yeah, I thought that was that. Thank you, and then everybody, thank you for what happened on Sunday and on the 8th of December. We are grateful to God, and everything will be fine. And according to the Election Commission, what we have saw yesterday, what we are seeing is improving for us, encouraging. We keep our momentum strong, and we keep getting better direction by to do the best a year to come. I don't want to talk much today. I'm too excited. I'm too happy. Everybody. Once again, they were moving around yesterday, waiting. I think yesterday I was a bit small. Therefore, high.
Thank you, my friend. I heard you. Thank you so much. And thank you so much for everything you've done, too. Let's take some more calls.
Good morning, my Monrovia.
Yeah, morning. Charles? Yeah. Morning, my hero.
Morning.
Yeah, you know what happened, David? These people can't even change that result. The Ethel Latanana has to pay. She moved to a new place, to a childhood friend place. I know they pay. You're not stupid, the Ethel Latanana. You're not stupid. After all, what they want you to wear, your government tell us, your boyfriend Joshua tell us, they want you to. They gave me wife. And to Costa, Jeremy last my son. Sorry, now, what they're going through for us, you almost got drowned in our river. Why you never about swimming? Now some of us are from Southeast that can swim. Why you never swimming? For all the things you went through, God was in it. It was just call. You know what I mean? The government to say they should extradite you and go intervene. So in this country, something is there for you. So relax. Sometimes you get fat temper. We understand every human being get their own attitude. And anything say, my dear. Sometimes you go express yourself. What is second you express it? That one we used to it. But just believe yourself. But you know, we are said, this country, because you'll be somebody. The first step is side yourself. He's getting out. Let him get in our car there to him, so let him start packing his loads. You start from there. Then from there, we'll know where you go. Relax. That country, we know other people, we need you. You can stay and say the truth. You will let your people, that you will be in Costa. The other thing they did yesterday, that police people, that they was intentional, they wanted to kill people. Pages through, you miss it. Joshua was frustrated because when he went to Canada, they drove in the course, he went to the hotel, they shot at him, he went to the loop. That's why he came. With frustration, but they said, then this job, he came in try something. Then my job, a cow, we talking about, in Guinea, what happened in Guinea, what happened here? That is here, what look like, Kino, he even thinking about it. A more better, he thinking about it. Let him try shit.
Okay, let me zoom.
All right, my boy, now, thank you very much. Let's take more calls there, folks.
Okay, the numbers are calling the show this morning, 0770102102 0886. Let's go back. Good morning. Good morning. Yes, good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Your name, where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Kenya Village.
Welcome to the program.
Yeah, I want to know, I always want to know, but I want to know why my tumor is not working.
Everything is working, my brother. All the viewers.
John, don't tell the man it's working. My tuna has been given a problem. Explain to him what is, how he can get it. The app, you can no longer listen to the app, but you can get it online or go to TuneIn. All right, my brother, thank you. Let him go off the line and let's explain to him. George?
I have a number already, because I
was... No, it's not about his number, George. There are others who are complaining. Eh? And we should take our time to explain to them. The MyTuna app no longer works. The app that you downloaded, MyTuna, is MyTuner. Those of you who are using it already know it, because there are multiple platforms, there are many platforms that we have. The MyTuna is one of them. It no longer works. So if you had the app in your phone, every morning you would just click on it and listen to us, you realize it no longer works. That's true. Don't tell it, man, it works. It does not work. So here's what you need to do. All of you who are listening to us via MyTuna, abandon MyTuna. Two options you have. Go to the website. That's www.roots1027fm.com. Let me repeat that for you. That's roots1027fm.com. That's the website. Simple. Tell our frequency when we had the radio station, 102.7, right? So it's roots1027. Don't put a 0.7. roots1027fm.com. You can catch us there, crystal clear. Now, the MyTuna, the app, George, it has been given problem. It has not been working, right?
It's working, hey, yeah, playing.
0.7, right? So it's roots1027.
So the app has started working again?
Yes, it has working. Same with Usado is. The app is working. MyTuna working, my tool working, the website, everything is on.
Oh, but you did not tell me that, George. You see, I don't know. So I'm saying to the people that it's not working because you did not tell me. Somebody else just told me that they are listening to it and that it is working. So my brother, maybe our brother has not checked it of late. So my brother, go and check it. It's working. George, play. George, you want to play that again? Play again so he can hear it.
Okay, then you like it.
Nah, it is working. I hear a lot of people tell me it's working just fine. Yeah, right now people are writing and they say it's working. And that's how they're listening to the show via the MyTuna. Because you know, a lot of people listen via. Because you see.
George, you want to play that idea? Play again so he can hear it.
Okay, then you like it.
You see that, folks? Yeah. That's my voice. That's my voice you're hearing on the MyTuna app. You see? So that's it's crystal clear. It's crystal clear. And the thing about the MyTuna and the tuning. Now we have MyTuna, we have TuneIn, we have the website, we have SoundCloud, we have YouTube, and we got Facebook. So we got 6 platforms that we use every day to do the show. 6. And there are tens of thousands of people listening to all these platforms. So the MyTuna is one of them. So it is working. But there was a time it was not working, George.
Yes.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. And the thing about it, it's cheaper to listen to the apps than to watch the show. Because to watch the show, video consumes more data. The audio is extremely cheap to listen. So I just want to let you all know, video consumes more data. Audio, just listen to the audio, minimum data is consumed. Let's go back to the lines, let's take more calls.
Okay. Good morning. Yes, good morning. Your name, where are you calling from?
I'm saying, calling from the oil road. Just a confirmation concerning what Costa is saying. I think MyTuna is working because I'm sitting right in my car and listening to him by MyTuna. So it's working.
Thank you, my brother. We appreciate it. Thank you so much. Thank you. Yeah, a lot of people saying they are listening to it. It's working perfectly. Thank you, my friends. Thank you. We really appreciate it. That's how a lot of people listen. MyTuna and all the other platforms and very good, very, very good. Fantastic. Let's take more calls, George. Today, we expect fresh results from the net.
Morning,
from. Good
morning,
Captain.
Morning.
Huh? I said,
Oh, okay. Welcome, welcome, my brother. William. Oh, William. William, morning. William, I apologize. I'm sorry. William, you see, I'm always so overwhelmed.
You should be aware regarding to your what will be up for some discussion. My internet is working. I'm using my internet on my phone this minute and this is the show. So be aware of discussion. My internet is working.
Thank you, William. No, I mean, that person perhaps they might have had some issues with it in the past and so they didn't know that it's back on. Thank you, William. William, hit me up today. Sometime later on today so we can talk. Thank you so much. Let's take some more calls. We've got about 30 more minutes or so to go. Morning, 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 Quito. Quito, give us an update about the young man in the hospital. First of all, what's his name? We need to know his name and we need to know his situation. I don't just want to keep calling him the young man. I want to be able to put a name to his to his face.
Yeah, the young man is doing fine. You better sleep in the hospital last night.
Thank you.
And after he woke up, somebody in the night he talk.
Thank God. And that's why we need to find something for them because now it's gonna hamper their hustle. Thank you, Quito. Thank you so much. Do you know his name? Quito, what is his name?
Hello?
He has his name, his full name.
What's the young man's name?
Yeah, okay. I can't remember his full name, but we can send it on the show. I'm about to the hospital leader.
All right. When you get there, let me have his name. And if he can talk, no problem. Let me talk to him.
All
right. And we're going to send some money today. A good friend of mine offered to give us some good cash to help him. So I'm going to send you some money today, yeah?
Okay, thank you.
Thank you so much. That's our strong, we call her the female militant of the COP. She's on her way to the hospital. She says she's almost there. And we care for our people. All the thing we do here is about the people. We don't let CDC walk and tell people say the party is supreme. The party mandate. In the COP, at least I can speak for COP, you know, because I'm the chairman of COP. In the COP, the people are supreme. They're not Costa, the people. So we care for every single person because that the people, one, they make the movement. So in our organization, the people are the ones who are supreme. So when something happens to one man, when something happens to one woman, we are concerned and we take care of them. Y'all know the way we can do it. We don't leave any man or woman behind. So we jump on there and we do our best for them. Yes, because you know what? When the people care for you, you should care for them back. That the mistake Joe we are making, that's the problem Joe we are has. The people care for him, but he does not care for them. That's why the people have disgraced him the way they have disgraced him. So we are not like that. My thing is, my philosophy is to care for people, to value people. You understand? Because everything we do is about the people. That is what we do. Let's take more calls, George, let's take more calls then. I hope when we get to the hospital, we can speak to this young man if he can talk. And I want to know his name. I want to know his name. I don't want to just call him young man. I want to know his name. She will give me the name. Let's take some more calls.
Good morning.
I'm told his first name is Abraham. Abraham is his first name.
Yes, I get it. You loud and clear. All
right. This is Noah. I'm getting here.
Noah, good morning, my brother.
Yeah, I come here. I'm always morning hearing your voice.
Same here, my brother. Same here.
This morning, for sure, we very big thank you. Beginning from you, leader. So, let me be very honest with you today. Let me express my happiness that everybody is hearing. I don't think the Liberian people should take you for granted.
No, I don't think they take me for granted either, Noah. Okay. I am honored.
Don't get me wrong. I'm not singling out the other people because of the role they play. But you have been very influential. you are playing your part, and you still playing your part. It is because of so many attention and people reporting that got us getting the kind of results that we are getting. I'm proud of you. I'm humble. I'm too humble. I mean, an honor.
Thank you, Noah.
Do you know what it means for the kind of sacrifices you have just made? Look at the kind of money you put in this process.
Oh, yes, the diaspora Liberians.
You are learning a more honor. And you know, look, Leo, I'm telling all the words I expect. Right now, in Liberia, you can see the sound of redemption coming to our country. I tell you, the people who are rejoicing all over the place, when you were hearing those fake results of Freedom FM, I mean, right now, they are, you don't even know that the government is in the country anymore, you know, they're too sorry for.
I'm telling you!
Most of the independent candidates are in control, again, they are connected to CCD.
Yes! That's true! People that know many Patikwa from Grand Cru, that United Parliament. Yeah, there are not many particular who win the Grand Cru. Now you know the parliament. What is the Jimon Smith from River Sense? Now you know the parliament.
You are a hero.
Thank you, my brother Noah. Thank you. Let me let you leave the line because you're making me emotional. Thank you, my brother. Thank you, Noah.
I remain loyal to you until the end.
Thank you.
I'm not just saying this because I'm happy. I'm saying this from my heart.
Thank you, Noah. Thank you.
But let it go recorded and see.
Thank you, Noah.
The people recording the playing out, and I even see happening in China with the men and push around our money 7 million hours. Do I ever bring the people recording? When you hear it,
Wow. Thank you so much, Noah. You know, I want to say this, George, after and even the woman from the woman who winning Babalu or Botokane is ANC. So the people that I also see CPP people winning, even the independent people who are winning their CPP, Eric Snow, that United Party. And you understand? So what I done Jimon Smith in River says that United Party man. The reason why he didn't run UPT is because that particular slot was given to Liberty Party. And Botokane, the lady from Bapolu who's leading, she's ANC through and through. The reason she didn't run on CPP ticket is because ALP was giving that slot. Imagine Nukwe, that CPP man, Nukwe, who went in Magibi. So all these people, no man, Botokane is ANC, my friend. She's not UP, she's ANC. But she's CPP, period. That's what matters. Wellington Jimon Smith in Riverside County. Unity Party. Botokane, who leading in Bapolu, ANC. Emmanuel Nukwe, CPP. Yanime, let go. All the people. You understand? All the people. So CPP won more than 12, 13 seats. The only seat that I know, the only seat that clear CPP, CDC people won, Grand Jire. And they won it only because of Zopeno they carry. Grand Jire County. Okay, then they won Sino. The reason they winning Sino, because Sino County, Egosin Chie, so the winning Sino, okay, Maryland County, and because Bani na MPP, Bani na CDC man, na MPP man, and you understand, Bani, James Bani, that MPP man, so those are the only three seats that that CDC really got. The rest of the other seats, that's also CPP people. Maryland County, Nukwe, yeah, but it's only because of Nukwe is MPP. So when you look at it, CPP won all over the place. Riverside County, Bapolu County, Edwin Snow, Bombing County. Let's go. You know, you all over the place. CPP won it. You know? So it's too bad for them. Of course, Lofa, United Party, Brandon Samuga, won it by a clear convincing margin. Let's take some more calls. So CDC really finished. We clear the thing.
Yeah, good morning, George.
Yeah, good morning, DJ Lover.
DJ Lover, morning, my brother.
Costa.
Morning.
Yeah, Costa, look, even in Maryland, yesterday there were a protest. In fact, the guy from the MPP, the former, he's not a former, but he's a senator. The seven.
Oh, you mean Dan Moraes?
Yeah, they are rating the election commission that they found this guy with a lot of ballot paper from the CDC. So they wrote the election commission yesterday and they called to make a clear on OKFM that now there's a problem in Maryland County. So we know they still said at the end of the day, Costa, look, if CDC will win, maybe they will win one or two counties. Besides that, they will have lost all. And I listened to Nathaniel McGee yesterday saying that it will be a sign if I come, then we will change the way. In fact, in Ghana, the president that won, he lost majority of the seats in the House, but he still won, so he's not a threat to 2023. That's a lie. If he lose, President Buhari will be one-time president in this country. And I hope and pray that it will come to pass. Because the people are suffering, Costa. The people are tired. The people are spoken. And at the end of the day, President, we have to set down your barrier. That's a mental way they can move. Now, Nathaniel McGee are there. We just want to coach and other people making the country so bad. Making the weather for the world day, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, I got a chicken in the mouth for Mr. President, you want time president. Gerard, Joe Moo, Junior, I mean Joe Moo, somebody in America that had Joe Moo in Liberia. Just take it to a prayer message for you. Take your hour, God bless you. We will win.
Our man, DJ Lome. But my man, I said, all over the play. CPP not play. They detected the comment. You see what we did? Yesterday, me and Steve Johnson were talking. We have redrawn the political map. That's what we've done. You know? We have. George, let's take some more calls.
Okay, the number for call this morning, the show 077-012-102-0886-0103-3. The other number for call, 0777-347-37-37. These are the number of the call on the show this morning. Good morning.
Good morning, Ben.
Yeah, good morning. The number
one calling from. Good morning, Cyrus.
Welcome.
Yeah. Thank you very much, dear, for the show. Like what Noah said, let me just add to that. Thank you for the hard work, the tireless work for the Liberian people. We really do appreciate. And we actually seeing the growth of that. And I can tell you from you, this country, we're about to take it from this year because they deserve it. These are all bunch of locals and knowledge that know nothing of governance. We can take that road back from them and make this country a better place for all that there. I wanted to draw something to attention, please. We should not forget these guys, they were announced, the result they are announcing, you know, they have the strategy that they put into place. They were announced the first result, you know, to ease the tension. And then, someone, they will want to manipulate the system, please. Yeah, I want each and every one of us to keep watching and be on their life. Because we can't allow these guys to take Maserati. And secondly, the boy name is Abraham. I am in communication with his sister as well. The boy who joined you on the night yesterday.
Thank you.
But you have a very hard selection that I can't remember. So, but I've been talking with his sister and the big brother as well. So thank you.
Thank you.
Okay.
Let's take some more calls.
Yep, no calls yet. The numbers are calling the show 077-012-102-086-0103-3830-0777-340-7337. Good morning.
Good morning. How are you, Josh?
Yeah, good morning. The name of what you calling?
Yeah. I'm calling from one of time.
Welcome to the program.
Thank you very much for the program, and thanks to Costa. This is a sad news that our brother from Timeco, more especially the Muslim who are to the other side, they refuse to go to the mosque because majority of our people from the local community that is pretending to be Sharia, they refuse to go in the mosque now to observe their five-day prayer, and that is Western. You can't have politics because you lose, and the people that have brought that belong to the local community, all majority are Muslim, because of that you begin to hate your own religion. That is very sad. So I'm appealing to them, continue to serve your law. They are serving your law, they have nothing to do with politics. Politics can just come and go. We have opposite 18% in the country we got, so you should go for your own worshiping. It's very sad. So my warning to them, that reconcile, we don't hate anybody. Even if we are winning, we don't hate you. And we know there's something to you to get on the CDC. So you can come back, come and observe your father in prayer. Don't be ashamed. We will not mock at you. We will not degrade you. And we'll say, consider you. Thank you.
Thank you, my brother. And I agree with you. Reconcile. Go back to your mosque. Pray with your people. Go back to your church. Pray with your people. And politics should not divide us. You know, the people spoke because they are suffering. That's their view. So go back to the mosque. Pray with your brothers. You know, Allah is there for all. He's not there for one group of people. Thank you.
Because I still want to go to Molu. Molu is your reason.
Yeah, Molu is your reason, but we're waiting to see.
Okay, I think I'll put something in the line. Good morning.
Hello, Bucket Tomorrow. Good morning, Bucket. Yeah. Tomorrow, good morning.
Morning, Pop.
Good morning. We can hear you.
Yeah. Okay, this is Google M. Tomorrow speaking to you. Congratulations, Pastor. I want to bring a test to. I'm bringing a study after this is too. Election, I ran back to Muslims. In Ghana City right now. I just came out last night. I got that city right now. It's really from Russia. Thanks, and I saw people from that region. I said that in the downfall. The wicked behavior are being gone. We are done well. And I saw people here to the affair, the fire. Then the camp police unit, not even for the police officer to come and stop the protest. We protect it by our part. Look at the water, people surely. They didn't want to come that road into war. And we can't do it. We are sensible enough. We love that road for the dignity. They only love the road for the attack. To lose our resources, to get our resources, and get off and come out of it. We share them in the final part. That we will keep thinking. And I want Mama Michael to resolve and set up the world. And come out of it. So I just said, it is the result of the world. And we get over. We get over all four. We are going to retire. But I thank you and I thank you God for us. We pay your money for the effort of God to save our Liberia, to save more Liberia. That's the only thing I'm going to have. Let's make our prayer God. And make our prayer God. Thank you.
Thank you, Pop. Let's take more calls, Josh.
No, cause yeah, because wait, you know how many left the country yesterday?
Who are men?
The spokesman for the cabinet team.
Akara's Gray. Yes, that's what I'm hearing. And he posted a picture of himself in the plane.
Yeah.
Akara's left the country. You know, I think the man go relax small, man.
Yeah. Listen to Abimbalu.
Yes, the Costa Show. Welcome, sir. Welcome.
Yeah, I want to cut down on my video right here. I come from a home in that OP community. Hello?
Yes, sir. We can hear you, my brother.
I am Samuel Zeb Bonyon. I work for Young Star TV like the US, which is playing in America. And where in the world, generally, we need no choice for freedom and saying the federal court, people telling you it's not doing well for the country. It's not doing well for this country. It's coming for everybody. Where in the world, no matter in the race, then you get 200 votes, then I get 300. Let me get it, you get 200, I get 50. You get 50, then I get 2. They are all you. They are the first many best information in the country. The country belongs to anybody. Alright? The country belongs to anybody. It's not every country or the country to be the matter of everybody ever simply. So I'm just told from reliable sources that despite the result of a good student, but they are trying to send around this afternoon when they're giving the other results.
They will not do that. Don't worry, my brother. They will not do that.
Yeah, I want to get here from real choice. Because this country for everybody, anything happening in the country will begin to run away. Media practitioners should be all over. Should be for Thomas Bryan, should be for Robert Dillon, should be for Mr. Costa, everybody. But don't say on freedom having against this new information. Yeah, the word freedom.
Yeah. All right, my brother. Thank you. Don't give them relevance. Don't talk about it. Yes, sir. They don't have any influence. They're wasting their time. No picking egg and just talk to sedition. They can't talk to nobody else. Even sedition, I believe them. Let's take calls there, George.
Okay, number to call the show this morning is 0770-102-102-08.
Now begin calling. It says CDC Costa. Don't get any relevance here, I beg you.
Good morning.
Good morning, brother.
Yes, good morning. You know where you're calling from?
Yes, I do call you for interview this morning.
Welcome to the program.
Yeah, so much to the director. What I would say is this. When I first say you have two kilos, you're going to get up and you look like, no, but we look here, look, because all you've got. The North Carolina, this is Henry Costa you're speaking to.
Hello.
Abby, can you hear me? Abby.
Abby, you hear Costa?
Abby.
Yeah.
This is Costa. Abby, I want to say sorry for what happened to you yesterday, and we feel very bad, but we thank God that you will not be losing your leg. We thank God you can even talk this morning, and we will stand with you, the COP family, And we will make sure you will receive the best treatment and everything will be fine with you, yeah? Okay. We're sending some money there to help with your mind and with your family people and to make sure you are well taken care of. Don't worry about anything, you hear me?
Okay.
All right, AB. Be strong. Be strong. We are with you.
Okay.
All right, thank you. Thank you very much. Well, folks, there you have it. That's Abraham. What's his last name, George?
Abraham Thomas.
Abraham Thomas. He's one of our strong supporters. He's a young man. He answered our call to go to the Liberty Party headquarters yesterday. And one of our people just sent $50 for him. $50, I have it here just now. One of our supporters. I don't know whether I should call the name, but one of our strong supporters. So we are with you. We are with you, and we stand with all of our people. And when something happens, let's take some more calls. Then we thank God for you that you are okay.
Yes. Where you calling from?
I'm Lamini Escona from Banga City.
Morning.
Thank you very much. I think the COP are trying to forget about we that living outside of Monrovia. And Monrovia is not, you know, the only base of the COP. COP is an organization all over Liberia. We endorse camera Costa. What it's doing for all the benefit is not belong to the people in Monrovia alone. It belongs to every one of us outside here. We wait outside in the we every morning we buy our data and listen to the man, you know, and we educate us. We also we reach to the other area where, you know, network are inaccessible, then we hopefully, you know, the recording to the people. So he has forgotten about us outside of Monrovia. And really it's not Monrovia alone that lost it. Thank you very much. So even get the Lancet by us here in current
Thank you, my brother.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, my brother. Sorry. I love you people too. You know, the brother from Bon County, he says that we should focus on them too. That the people in Monrovia are not the only one who love us. That's true. We love you too. We will extend our operations there. That's our focus going to 2021. We're going to set up our offices across the... We're going to set up chapters across the country. We will set up in Banga. We'll set up in Ganta. We'll be in other parts of the country. That's what we're going to do. Thank you so much. And I love you all too. We are coming to Bon County. And the COP is not only for Monrovia. We are for the whole country. So we are coming. We are working on it. We are coming. We'll be there. And we love you all too. We love you all too. Let's go back to the lines. Let's take some more calls there.
Good morning, Pedro. This is Asmala Kamal.
You know, I want to find out from Quinto Bryan, who's at the hospital with AB. The $50 our supporter just sent for him. I want to send the money to, at least send it to the hospital now. And I want to send it by send wave. Josh?
Yeah.
Find out from Guido Bryan what was sent with number or mobile money account number so I can send this the $50 the person just sent so I can send it to Guido for Abraham Thomas at the hospital. Tell me, brother Thomas, to just hold on there. So let's talk to him, then we'll talk to Guido. Guido, if you're listening, send me your mobile money number so I can send you the $50 that the person just sent.
Brother Thomas?
Mr. Thomas? Ansumana Thomas?
He got off on the man.
We're very sorry. That's Mr. Ansumana Thomas. We're very sorry. But hey, the situation with the young man, AB, in the hospital is important. So I want to send this $50 that the sister just sent right now so that we can have our picking in the hospital. We're going to help him and his family so that they ain't got to be worried. You know, the way the time high, you know, they got to be worried about and paying medical bills, they don't have to worry about that. And even they don't have to worry about food at the house. We're going to take care of all of that. We're going to do that. That's what we do for our people. We never let our people down. So let's get the number from Quito Bryan, her mobile money number, so I can send her this $50 right now. George, let's go back to the line. Let's take some more calls then.
Okay, the numbers are calling the show this morning.
So we got 10 more minutes to go and then we're done.
610-2883, your other numbers to call, 0777-3407-27. These are the numbers to call this morning on the show.
Okay. Let's see where we get. We got some calls there. We'll take them. And you're listening to the Costa Show. Today is Friday, the final day of the final edition of the show for the week.
Thomas back on the line.
Huh?
Oh, we lost it again. I don't know why.
No, we don't need to speak to Thomas. We need to speak to Queen O'Brien. We will give her that money so that she can get it and give it to him.
Okay. And don't call us yet.
Okay. Yeah, so that's what we're gonna do. Alright folks, we've got 10 more minutes to go. And we're gonna take we will be leaving shortly and I just got something. Hold on, let me put this up. yes, the issue of the website, of course. They gave me word, and I have a credible source at the NEC who has informed me that the website was taken down. That the website was taken down by the NEC themselves. They took the site down. And they're working on the site. They're working on the site because it was overwhelmed with traffic, and so they took it down themselves and they are working on it. That is why the site is down. That is the information I received, that the website is down. I'm not giving you information from NEC officials. I'm giving you information from a credible source of mine whose loyalty lies, well, with us. With the country. I know this source, and the source tells me, and I trust this source implicitly, that the site is down because of traffic. It was overwhelmed, and so they took it down to do maintenance work. If it did not come from this source that I trust, that I've known and trusted for a long time, I would not be telling you. That's what I wanted to say. So the site should come back up this afternoon. That is what I'm told, according to the source. The site of the NEC, the National Elections Commission, will be back up this afternoon. I just thought to point that out. You know, we're taking, if there are no more calls, this is the weekend, we're really tired, we're exhausted. This week has been very difficult, as you can understand, so, you know.
Yes, you're back.
Mr. Thomas.
Good morning, Pedro.
Morning, sir.
Thank you to all that you are host to find those yet your voices. This election was meant for all that you and I appreciate all of you coming up. And I felt so emotional this morning when Raul Gibson was speaking. Pedro, you are the voice of the people. Okay, you have had an impact on the political landscape in Liberia. And we stand firm behind you, we support you, whatever you're going to do. And I just want to say thank you for our full watcher who remain vigilant as well as the counting continues. Thank you to all our viewers.
Okay, my brother.
George, do we have another caller?
No.
Okay. Well, folks, it looks like this is how we're going to bring this to an end. Thank you so much. God bless you all. And have yourselves a wonderful, wonderful, beautiful weekend. Again, I want to say shout out to Timandra. Happy belated birthday. Yesterday was your day. I wish you all the best. I hope you had a wonderful day. I'm sure you had a wonderful birthday. And have a lovely weekend to all of our folks. And this brings us to an end of today's broadcast. It has been interesting. This has been a great weekend. I mean, a great week, historic week, tension packed, interesting to say the least. And we're grateful for everything that you, the people, have done for us, standing with us, believing in us, giving us, reposing your confidence in us. We assure you that we will ensure, even though I'm not one of those who was elected, but we will ensure that those in whom you have placed your confidence will serve you as you expect them to serve you. That's our job, to ensure that they do. We will not settle for anything less than that. And that is what we're going to commit ourselves to. So that's it. If you're looking to send money to Liberia, you have to look no further. SendWave is the way to do it. Yes, Big Brother Ansumana Tamas is asking for the number to send something to Abraham. I will give him the information. And so that's it, folks. We love you. Take care. Have yourselves a wonderful weekend. And take it easy with our CDC brothers, as I've said to you. They themselves are hurting. They're hurting because they lost.
Even though it's not our fault. We beat them, but it's not our fault. It's their leaders' fault. They cost it. They brought it upon themselves.